Hi friends, Casey Cooke with Coldwell Banker Residential Brokerage here in Vista, California, short sale and foreclosure expert. I want to take a couple of minutes. I get a lot of questions about deficiency judgments. This is one of the biggest concerns people have with a short sale or with foreclosure. Either one, deficiency judgments are a big question. So I want to take a couple of minutes and I want to talk about what they are, and then I also want to talk about how a short sale actually protects you, the homeowner, from a potential deficiency judgment. So first, what is a deficiency judgment? So in California, and again, I'm talking specifically about California, so if I have viewers from out of state, remember I'm talking about California. A deficiency judgment is the imposition of personal liability on a borrower for the unpaid balance of the mortgage debt after a foreclosure or short sale has failed to yield the full amount of the debt which was due and owing at the time of the foreclosure. So basic typical scenario is homeowner owes $600,000 on the home. They bought it a couple of years ago. It's now worth $350,000, $400,000. We sell it for that amount and the net proceeds on the sale are insufficient to pay off the existing loan. The difference there is unpaid. Also, it could be in a foreclosure. Say a home goes to foreclosure and there's multiple loans on the property. The first lender forecloses, the second lender commonly doesn't get anything, and depending on the type of note, there could be a potential deficiency judgment. So that's what a deficiency judgment is, the unpaid balance after a foreclosure or a short sale, and it's the imposition of personal liability on you, the borrower, after that sale. So that's what it is. Let's talk a little bit about how a short sale protects you, the borrower, from a deficiency judgment. So there was a new law, a state code, a civil code, that went into effect this year. It's SB, or Senate Bill 458. So here's what Senate Bill 458 did. Effective July 15th, so it went into effect on July 15th, 2011. So any homes sold through a short sale after this date are covered by SB 458. It amended the code of the Civil Procedure Section 580. It amended that code to expand anti-deficiency protection to both the first and second loans. It actually covers any subsequent liens as well, or loans as well. So if you had three loans, four loans, five loans, and you did a short sale, you're protected under this SB 458. And what it means is there's no deficiency judgments after a short sale. So this is great news for homeowners who are struggling and decide to short sell the home. What this says is if your lender or lenders agree to a short sale, they agree to take the net proceeds of the sale, what's left after all commissions and closing costs are paid, in full and final satisfaction of your debt, and you never have to pay that back. So it wipes out the chance of a deficiency judgment after a short sale. So that's what it is, and that's how a short sale protects you, the borrower, from a deficiency judgment. So the next question is, you know, what do we do next? If you have questions about short sales, if you're curious if a short sale is right for you and you want to set up a one-on-one consultation with me where we can go over all of this stuff, use the box below me to input your data, your email address, phone number, your name, and if you want to give me some notes about the situation, put your data in the box below. I will personally follow up with you within 24 hours, and we can talk further. So again, that's a little bit about deficiency judgments and short sales in California. I hope that was helpful. If I can help you with anything further, please let me know. Thank you again.